Okay, so first off, we've got that lawsuit against Steam's 30% cut of game sales is now a class action, meaning many other developers could benefit. Here we go.
It's a very professional title. That lawsuit. You know, the one.
Well, Rock, Paper, Shotgun is only got the greatest journalists, for sure. They definitely play video games and love them. Okay, so, yeah, this is, again, just devs seething about the 30% cut, and it's like, this is a very, very simple transaction you're doing here. You're paying for basically exposure. I hate to say it, but yes, it's the biggest platform, at least, you know, PC platform by far to sell games on. I mean, it's not even a close second place. So, yes, yeah. It is a huge cut. Obviously, but I mean, listen, I wouldn't even care. I'm not invested in Valve's future at all. You know, you already know that I'm not even close to a PC Master Race guy. So I don't care about any of that shit. What I do care about is that the game store is a piece of shit. Like, it's absolutely, I hate using it. In fact, I haven't used it in like a year at least. It's not worth it.
Yep. And the 30% really isn't that bad when you consider they eat all of the credit card costs, you know, because like Visa takes a cut and stuff like that. They also eat any costs that comes with chargebacks. So like, if you are selling the game yourself, you could end up like losing money if too many people refunded or charged back their cards and stuff.
Right.
So Valve eats all of that. They also provide servers and stuff for games. I mean, it's not like they don't do anything. It's not like the 30% is just because fuck it.
Okay, I just read a quote here that is... This is some retard shit. Okay. I believe that Valve is taking away gamers' freedom to choose how much extra they're willing to pay to use their platform.
What?
Yeah, and then, the quote continues, I believe they're taking away competing stores' freedom to compete by taking advantage of their lower commission rates. I believe they're taking away developers' freedom to use different pricing models.
Okay, so this is a bad quote, because I think what he's trying to get at is that if you sell your game on Steam, you're not allowed to sell Steam keys somewhere else for a lower price.
Yeah.
Because if you sell a Steam key, Steam doesn't take 30%. It doesn't take anything, right? But to compensate for that, you're not allowed to sell Steam keys like 30% cheaper somewhere else or something, you know?
Right, yeah.
So I think that's what he's talking about.
Yeah, well, regardless, this is just one of those things where... Like, this is something that the gamer does not give a fuck about.
Yeah, has nothing to do with the gamer.
And I have no sympathy for game developers anymore. I mean, you know, if they actually cared about making good games, and this doesn't just apply to devs, obviously it's publishers as well, but the point is nobody in the industry actually wants to make a good game. They either want to make propaganda or, you know, a minimum viable product, and that's it. It's like nobody, like, I want to make the most fun video game that I can. It's gone. It's fucking gone. So
it's just because you hate indie games.
Fuck all these people. Yeah, and you play them and you hate them just as much as I do.
Yeah, but the problem isn't that they're not trying. It's just that they're not good.
Yeah, because they're soulless golems. Okay, if they... We don't need to really get into this discussion because, again, I feel like I'm just repeating myself for the millionth time that I've said on streams and stuff, and people have explained it better than me anyway, but the whole theory that all the great artists, you know, basically just, you write what you know, and I think the same sort of applies to any artistic medium, and the people who are making games are just imitating the things they grew up with instead of making things based on their experiences, right?
Yeah, well, no one has any experiences anymore.
Yeah, so everything is like soulless clones of something else.
You can make a game about, you know, calling someone on the phone without having a panic attack.
I mean, that
probably
exists.
Have made that game.
Yeah, I can totally see that existing as like a a psychological horror game. It's literally just about social anxiety, calling people on the phone. Like, itch.io has like 10,000 fucking games that are just like 5-minute slop shit like that. So,
well, there is about 100 million games about depression. So,
yeah,
we need more about anxiety, even it out.
Okay, well, moving on. This is a funny piece of news here.
I like this one, yeah.
Billionaire internet company boss turns up to real life 1v1 against COD player angry about lag. I mean, this is
so based.
Xavier Neal, founder of telecoms company Iliad, shocked the X/Twitter user who challenged him by actually turning up outside a Lidl supermarket in Marseille, France. That's fucking crazy, dude.
Yep. And he pussied out.
Yep.
The other guy, he's like, where you at? Come on.
That's nuts. Yeah. I honestly don't have too much to say about this. This is one of those things where, I mean, so much crazy shit happens in the modern day like this that, you know, I'm almost desensitized to stuff like this, but yeah that
scroll
is insane.
Bottom. Look at, like, what the guy said, why he didn't show up. There, it's right there.
I would have liked to, but 34.2 temperature plus stomach ache plus headache. Sorry, I give up. Oh, my God.
You pussy. I mean, it's like, this is, like, extra gay because if he actually showed up, he probably just would have, like, shook his hand and been like, you know, how can we improve your experience or whatever? And it'd be like a funny anecdote or whatever.
Yep. Yep. Lidl themselves also got in on the action, posting, please come and pick up the man who has been tweeting since this morning in front of the store. That's funny. Okay. Well, all right. Now we got some shitting on PlayStation news.
French person surrenders, by the way. Had to.
Oh, yeah. French person surrender. Yeah. Well. Classic. Horizon Zero Dawn Remastered fails to impress, falls behind original in concurrent player count. And this is basically a double piece of news because the other one is also new. This is, I don't know why they titled it like this. I guess it's more clickbaity. New PlayStation game is performing worse than Concord on Steam, that being the Lego Horizon Adventures game. So, we had double bombs back-to-back of the most astroturfed video game protagonist of all time, Aloy.
Yeah, what is the brain damage that has caused Sony to go all in on a character nobody likes?
Well, part of it, I think, is, I can't actually remember if it's a Sony exec or that just the creator, Hellman Hurst, I think his name is. He's absolutely fucking obsessed with Aloy and is trying to push her in everything, and nobody likes her at all. I mean, I played the first game. It was fine. If I played it now, I'd probably hate it more because I've played so many sandbox games now. But back when it came out, it was like, this is all right. You know, the robot dinosaur thing is, you know, that's cool, but everything else is kind of boring. And it was extremely diverse. You know, it's one of those games that's really pushing for. And look, they had a story reason, not a good one, but they had a story reason, which was the reason why it's so diverse is because everyone who is alive in this far future is just a clone of people from the past. And so I guess because they were woke as fuck or something, they made sure there was even racial and sex distribution for all the people who were cloned, you know. And the smartest person ever was a woman and is Aloy. Aloy is a reincarnation of, like, the smartest woman ever, which is like, man, that's so cringe.
It's funny because the obsession with Aloy, like, people were excited for the first Horizon game, but it was just because of the cool robots and nothing else.
Yep.
But they keep putting the focus on this, like, goblin creature rather than the cool robots.
Yeah, I mean, the first game was, you know, I won't say ugly in an artistic sense, but everyone just looked normal, right? Everyone looked normal. And then the second one, they're like, oh, everyone's ugly now. Because we love ugliness, because we're leftists, and that's what we do. We make ugly art.
Yeah.
And it was just more of the same as well. You know, I played like, I don't know, 15 to 20 hours of it, and it was just like the first game. And people wonder why nobody cared. You know, I guess you can only bundle it with so many fucking consoles. There was actually a tweet I saved on my phone. I just remembered it right now, though. But basically, Phil Spencer is like, yeah, even the PS5 I bought came with Horizon. That's just, everyone has Horizon because it's bundled with every PlayStation.
Yeah, I think they're trying to just take a loss to, like, push the character, but it's not happening. Like, it's just not working. It's a bad character design, and nobody cares.
Yep.
Like, they could just push Kratos in the same way, you know?
But he's
like,
a white man.
Like, make a Lego Kratos game, and maybe people would have played that.
I mean, he's a cucked white man, but he's still a white man, so he can't be the forefront anymore.
Fair. Well, they could just make him black.
His voice is already black. Yeah,
he's
so.
Already voiced by a black guy. Just make him black. It's fine. He'll be the first Greek black man.
Yeah, well, you know, depends on what historian you ask.
Oh, yeah. Actually, Greeks were always black, so yes. He's supposed to be black. They'll just be returning him to what he was supposed to be.
Shit, there was David Jaffe-related news, but that's not that important. I don't care. David Jaffe's the creator of God of War, or one of them. And his biological daughter transitioned to a man, and then David Jaffe lost his fucking mind and became super woke or whatever. And
oh, damn.
Yeah.
Usually the opposite happens. They usually breaks. Oh, no, it always breaks the parent. So I guess it's a 50-50 whether they become Elon Musk or, I guess, super woke.
Yeah, and I don't know. He shit on some... I don't. Was it a YouTuber woman or something? This is recent. I don't care that much about the drama. Some conservative female content creator or whatever. Something like that. Okay, so, right. So Sony is trying to buy Kadokawa, which is the parent company for From Software.
Dark Souls.
Let's see. Yeah, wait. What else did they... Does Kadokawa own that you were mentioning?
The big one that I actually care about is they own Spike Chunsoft, which means goes through, no Pokemon Mystery Dungeon ever again. They're the only good games ever made. All their video games are bad.
Yeah. This is interesting, though, because Bandai Namco owns Dark Souls and Elden Ring, I believe, as well. So I don't think they would get that, would they? Yeah, because they're not trying to buy Bandai Namco. It's weird. Anyway, the point is, obviously Sony owning From Software would be bad for everyone. I know a lot of my fans... What's up?
Who cares? I mean, Dark Souls has been going down the shitter for the last...
I was literally about to cover your take in a second. This is where they're like, a base Devin Kino.
Yep.
Don't worry, I told Devin about the Devin Kino comment that was on the community post. I saw it. Anyway, so yes, I was about to say, my audience and Devin apparently... don't care because, you know, yeah, From Software hasn't really made an awesome game in a long time. Normies love Elden Ring, and some people in my audience love Armored Core. I thought the last one was all right. I really was not that impressed. It wasn't, like, that fun to actually play. I mean, it was cool conceptually, visually, but I think the execution was kind of weak in certain ways, but... I'm not going to go into that again. The point is, I have not been impressed with a From Software game since Bloodborne. And yeah, this is the part where people say Sekiro, and it's like, listen, maybe someday I'll go back to it, but I don't care.
I mean, it's like a rhythm game without music. I guess it's like semi-interesting, but not very fun. Oh, they'd buy it. People will make the Mario and Luigi games? That's crazy. Oh, only the most recent one. I heard that one's not that good. Oh, they made Octopath too. Those are pretty good. Oh shit, they'd own RPG Maker?
Yeah, sorry, whoa. That's
anyone who likes porn games, it's time to stock up while you have the chance.
Well, I'm sure
there's no way Sony's gonna let that happen anymore.
I'm sure RPG Maker is one of the biggest like pirated programs, so.
Yeah, but they would own they would probably change the license to make it so that you can't sell porn games.
Yeah, they could do that. They could do that. That would be interesting.
I mean, it'd be funny, but I think there are a lot of people in your audience specifically who would be upset.
Yeah. I hate Sony, so I hope that, you know, From Software or Kadokawa says, no, it's not worth it, but who knows, man. I mean, when you're throwing around billions.
What Kadokawa said is they're not selling From Software. Sony would have to acquire the entire company.
Yeah.
And I think it was like $4.1 billion, which is doable, but a lot.
You'd think at some point these fucks would run out of money because, like, I swear, again, I'm not the type of guy who looks at all these, you know, I don't look at companies' quarterlies to know how they're doing outside of, like, headlines that get posted sometimes. But we know Sony's hurting in the gaming division. Sony's movies are pretty hit or miss. I don't know how their hardware sales are doing outside of gaming, like with headphones, TVs, that sort of thing. I have no idea.
Apparently Kadokawa also makes a bunch of anime. None of it seems super great, like Shield Hero or Eight Alive.
Right.
So I wouldn't cry about it.
Yeah.
But maybe we'll get a cool Horizon Zero Dawn anime. Are you excited for that?
You remind me of that anthology series. Oh, shit, when does that come out? I think that's about to come out. I need to look it up because I might review it. But Netflix or is it Amazon? No, I think it's Amazon. Amazon's doing an anthology animated video game show called Secret Levels, where each episode is about a different video game. One of them is Concord, by the way, which is like a holy fuck. Like, that's hilarious. I want to at least review that episode, but I'll probably review the whole thing. It's just one thing because I doubt they have much substance. But yeah. Yeah,
that'd be cool if it was well done, which you know it won't be.
Yeah, no, there's no way it's gonna be well done, which is sad because, like, I liked the first season of Love, Death, and Robots. Not all of them, but I liked... That was Netflix, though. But regardless, the point is, like... Fuck, whatever. Who cares? I liked that anthology series. Yeah, the concept's good. Avowed art director exposed by Elon Musk for... Well, I don't care about the Elon Musk part. Whatever. For alleged racist and illegal hiring practices, Musk, it won't end well for him. Okay, well, I don't care about the Elon Musk Association. The point is, the art director... For Avowed, Matt Hansen. Yeah. Okay, I'm skimming. So Matt Hansen, the art director for Avowed, is a typical far leftist, anti-white, racist type of, you know, he hates chuds, obviously. Yep. Hates Elon Musk, hates Grums, Big Shock, you know, that's all these people, really. I don't care about Grums, and I only slightly care about Elon Musk.
Who is Grums? I see his profile picture all the time.
Is Mark Kern, who was a World of Warcraft game developer who became a chud at some point. And all you need to know is the people who hate me hate him even more. Like, he's one of the most hated person among certain groups, for sure.
That's good.
Like, anytime he's mentioned, there's, like, nuclear seething, and I have no idea why. So, Matt Hansen wants to tank the entire game. Basically, like, Elon Musk is like, okay, let me show you the elite. This is the... Sorry about if you're exposed to Aspen Gold here.
Oh, my God, it's the Gopher Man.
Very cringe. Reminder to black artists out there who are looking for portfolio reviews or job advice. My DMs are open and you will always have my priority. We got too many crusty white dudes in this field. Please let me help you replace me one day. I want to go back to living in the woods. Now, the first thing I want to point out is Matt Hansen is Jewish. So, depending on who you ask, he's not white. So
that's absurd what you just said. There's no way that could be true.
So yeah, I don't think he's white, at least in my opinion. You know, my very professional opinion. So
are you calling me not white? Who do you think you are?
But so he wants to replace whites. That's always good. But Elon Musk said something about how, you know, this is illegal or whatever. And then Matt Hansen said, all right, now I really want to do it. Don't embolden me, I believe is what he said. Oh, here we go.
Yeah.
A CEO of Microsoft. Yeah. Okay. And then, oh yeah, this is crazy. Chris Avellone actually sided with with the Chuds.
Which one's Chris Avalon?
He wrote New Vegas, and he wrote Older
Fallout. Is he the one who's like trying to be a YouTuber?
No. The reason why he's becoming a Chud is because there was some a Me Too style accusation went against him a few years ago. And so ever since those false accusations got him fired from a bunch of shit, he's
nothing left to lose.
Yes.
That's what a Chud is. That's what makes you a
Chud. He's not a true Chud, obviously, but he is like he's disillusioned with the left somewhat.
Yeah.
So, yeah, here we go. So here's the response to Elon Musk's tweet is, "Oh, Elon, you sweet summer child, this will only embolden me, you sad sack of shit."
If you say sweet summer child, execution in Minecraft.
Yes. Yeah, he's a gay Redditor art director, which is why Avowed looks horrific, by the way. I probably should have prepared pictures of how bad some of the character designs look. Maybe I could just pull up the trailer real quick. Well, we can check out Avowed's latest trailer.
Isn't it so weird that all these people who are obsessed with everything other than making a good game make bad games? Isn't that weird?
Yeah. It's crazy how fucking horrible these games are. All right, hold on. I will just show the trailer. I don't give a shit about
the copyright shit. It's a Semitic art style.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oy vey, you can't say that. Let me pause the music.
Yeah, dude, this just looks like you stole it from the Unreal Engine store.
Yeah, someone was showing the face animations are like horrific. I mean, they're worse than like New Vegas. I mean, even like that 1 second, you could tell the lip sync was off. Oh my god, yeah, premium skins.
Why were people pretending they were?
You see how ugly these characters are?
Dude, the furry. Go back. Scroll
yeah,
back.
Yeah,
that furry
yeah.
Character.
The furry looks utterly unappealing.
Like, really,
like,
you couldn't hire one gay furry to make
what
something that doesn't look
this?
Like a monstrosity?
It looks so fucking bad. It looks so
that
bad.
Really, that's what's that movie? Cats? That looks like
yeah,
Cats.
Yeah. This whole game is just, I don't know. And even when even when you're not seeing the horrific characters, it just looks very generic. And
one
the thing
kind
is,
of reminds me of is Kingdom of Amalur.
Yeah. Yeah, but this plays like Skyrim, basically, is what the gameplay is.
Yep.
Oh, okay. That was the last piece of news,
copies,
I guess.
Though, I'm sure.
But yeah, Avowed, you know, don't buy it. It's gonna be woke as fuck. I mean, the art director said it's gonna be woke as fuck.
Yeah, but you didn't need this. You shouldn't have needed these tweets to know to not buy it.
Yeah, I agree. I agree. It looks gay as shit. You just watch the trailer and you're like, this is gross. I don't like it. And that is the irony, though, where it's like the art director is the one raging about this. You take one look at the game and it looks like ass. It's like,
yep.
Interesting.
Man, maybe you focused more on, you know, the art part. What's your fucking job? The game wouldn't look like shit.
Yep. I'm sure chat loves when jets are flying overhead. Though I think they can only hear it when I'm talking. If I just leave dead air, then they'd never know.
Yeah, because Discord tries to hold it. Or hide yep. it.
Okay, so yeah, I think that's about it. Even though that was 2 weeks worth of news, I don't think there was that much else worth talking about. I could talk about Breakers. But chat already saw
yeah,
Breakers.
The state of Breakers. Right
the state
now?
Of Breakers is game's dead.
Wait, show your Poir. Show Poir.
Oh, yeah. Oh my god, I can't. Believe it, guys. Poir. Holy shit. Poir, dude. I got a Poir.
Yay.
Anyway, so.
Now, chat, you agree we should give Poir to our dogs? They deserve it.
Yeah, dude. That's what my brother tried to do. Like, immediately. Listen, I think I actually, even though it was 2 weeks ago, I already talked about this last time. There's no fucking content. The game's dead. You know, Breakers is dead.
Yep.
I've already exhausted everything. The new Raider is shit, by the way. Shit. Because the Zoomers who play the game have decided to... Let me see if I can just play a clip for you of what he says. And then, long story short, you didn't watch the Dragon Ball Super Heroes movie. Which, speaking of which, we didn't even really watch anime, but we can talk about movies. We'll talk about that
in
a second.
Oh, yeah, we never watched Akira. Damn.
Yeah, we never watched Akira. We did watch a few movies over the Thanksgiving period week. The week of Thanksgiving, you might as well consider.
Where do you have Poir in your room, Kobe?
I just put it on my desk, but it was on my shelf behind me.
He was behind it. So he watches you, goon.
Yeah, and he's smiling about it. You know, speaking of far and gooning, that was one Dragon Ball related thing I did watch. Instead of watching Daima, I watched like the first 5 episodes of OG Dragon Ball. I know I said I would never watch it, but I was like, fuck it. Someone cut together, you know, the episodes is like a movie. It kind of like, well, I don't even remember the YouTuber name.
Like
the point is, there's another guy who did it. And yes, it's structured kind of like Kai, but they just cut together an arc into like an hour and a half, right? And like, I remember people saying for years, and you know what? I'm still in the beginning, so I guess there's still a time for him to redeem himself. But people were saying for years, like, oh no, Yamcha's cool in Dragon Ball. And the whole time I'm thinking like, that sounds like bullshit. Sounds like complete bullshit. In his first episode, he gets humiliated multiple times. Goku knocks one of his teeth out, dude. Like, if a child beats you up, I don't care if he's fucking an alien, which, you know, at the time, I'm sure Toriyama didn't even think of that. I was just thinking of Sun Wukong, right? Since it's just Journey to the West is basically what OG Dragon Ball is.
So Yamcha's just always been a shitter.
Yeah, Yamcha's always been a shitter. Like, but Poir's there, and I'm like, oh, I love Poir. Anyway.
I love Poir.
But Poir is just Yamcha's yes man. He doesn't do anything either. Fucking... I don't know, like, what I was saying to you earlier, and something I wanted to talk to Chad about the last stream, but I forgot, is basically, like, OG Dragon Ball is just a Saturday morning cartoon. And you know what? I like Saturday morning cartoons. I still like some, you know, you guys know I love my baby games and shit, so I'm not saying I dislike Dragon Ball. I definitely don't dislike it. But, like, for the few contrarians who are like, no, Dragon Ball is actually better than Dragon Ball Z. Like, I get it. Some people are saying that because of the Demon King Piccolo arc, so I have to watch the whole show to get to that, obviously. Because I'm not going to skip stuff. I'm just not that type of guy. But, like, you're telling me this is like a baby cartoon. I know this is a bad comparison because my brother unironically likes The Hobbit more than Lord of the Rings, at least with the books.
Fuck you.
But to me, it's like saying The Hobbit is better than Lord of the Rings. It's like, what do you mean?
It is,
like,
though. If you read the book, I don't get Lord of the Rings. It's The Hobbit just feels like a more contained story, while The Lord of the Rings is very meandering.
Well...
Look, people are saying Hobbits, but anyone who's read the book, I think, agrees. Like, if the movies, it's obviously worse. The Hobbit movies are terrible. But if you read the books, which I know none of you can read, so don't lie to me, but those who have read the books know The Hobbit's better.
Oh, you played Shadow Generations. I can't believe it.
Oh my god, I told you, chat, that every podcast I would bring a gayer game. And this is the peak. It's a Sonic game. The gayest thing I could play.
I guess here's me streaming it. Whatever.
I didn't save my footage because I knew Kobe had some.
I got footage. All right, you talk about what you thought of Shadow Generations.
Dude, it's okay. It's fine. I like the open world part.
That's crazy. Levels. That's the worst part.
Yeah, I don't know. I just don't like Linear Sonic that much. I'm just collectathon brained. If you make a collectathon of any kind, it doesn't matter how bad or good, I will love it. So really, I was just like rushing through what I feel are shitty linear levels just so I can get to the open world to run around and have fun. And the problem is the open world like gates you with stuff. Like, you'll find a chest and it'll be like, no, you need the poop emblem from the poop levels. And I'm like, oh great, I guess I had too much fun and now I have to go back to playing the shit linear levels that I hate. I thought they were fun, but I don't know, it's so much of it is just holding forward and not really doing anything else.
I mean, that's just a lot of Sonic period, though, is just holding forward. I will give it this, though. Like, again, as someone, I played almost every level. I stopped at the worst level because I just didn't care, which is the last one. But I played all of the levels except one of Sonic Generations, like, a couple weeks ago, instead of playing the yearly games like I was supposed to. Like, this level design is way better. Like,
I 100% agree with you. I definitely liked Shadow Generations way more than I liked original Generations.
Yeah,
I did not like Generations.
Yeah, Sonic Generations is like, it's a glorified 2D game with like really shittier Well, I can't say this for certain because I haven't played Sonic Unleashed in so long, but it feels like shittier versions of Sonic Unleashed levels for the 3D, and then the 2D is just like, some is good, some is bad. The Shadow Generations 3D is like way better. Like this is probably the third best Sonic game in my opinion, and you hate it, but whatever.
I want to see if it happens to you, but the fucking Mantis Ray thing, if you hit a wall, will just launch you in a random direction, and it's the most annoying shit ever. I want to see what happens in this clip.
It might have been a bug, I don't know.
I think it's just shitty controls. Like Sonic... Okay, you only use it for like 2 seconds. But I think this game, Sonic controls pretty well, which is weird, because Sonic always controls like shit.
It's Shadow, excuse me.
Yeah, same character. If the federal government confuses them, then so do I.
yeah, that's true.
What's the fucking goo ball called? It's like Black Morph or something.
I don't remember. The squid?
The squid. I fucking hate the squid. It controls like ass. It is the only thing in this game that I'm like...
I agree, actually.
I just hate being this. I hate everything about
it. Yeah, let me show... we could show the final boss, because you were trying to... S rank this, right?
Yeah, I only played it twice. The after the second time, and then I was like so far off, I'm like, fuck that.
Yeah, it took me like 45 minutes.
The only thing I didn't S rank was the final boss, and I'm like, no, I don't care.
Yeah.
Because the S ranks are a joke in this game. I don't know why they did that. Like, most of the S ranks are like impossible to fuck up. Like, if you just spam the slowdown time, you'll always have plenty of time.
Yeah, pretty much. All right, let's see. Was this the last retry? Probably. I think I had to pee because I was so pissed. Because the thing is, the last phase is easy, but I was so mad that
spoilers,
I kept
Kobe.
Fucking
spoilers.
It up.
Spoilers! Everyone's spoilers.
Yeah. Oh my god, Black Doom is the final boss? Whoa, no fucking way.
I would never believe that.
Yeah, the only thing... You didn't
Ooh,
do
you
was
one.
The I know I thought it was over, but I'm like, fuck it, I'll just keep going anyway. You don't have to literally hit every single one, but you do have to hit almost all of them to do it fast enough. But the point is, like, that you learn from the harder version of the Metal Overlord fight that you save all the time on the first part.
Yeah,
and then the other part, the only thing that's important for the last part is obviously you just don't get hit. Because if you get hit, then you lose an insane amount of time. And that's about it. But, I don't know. So, the bosses, yeah, they're kind of a mixed bag with this, but... I don't think it's that important. I mean, I don't know.
I think only one boss I liked, and it was the Metal Sonic. I think it's the only boss I actually enjoyed. I think the other ones were inoffensive, but they weren't fun.
Yeah. Yeah, so, yeah, the squid part, this part I had to redo a shit ton of times.
Yeah,
just because, the squid controls kind of weird. But
there's no way to explain it other than it just feels bad. Like, what you want to do never happens. Like, it's not.
Yeah.
I hate it. I just hate it. Everything else is fine. It's only the squid that they fucked up.
Yeah, I agree. I do agree. It's only because... That's a good test if your controls are good, is like, how frustrated do you get when there's a real challenge put in front of you? And you just get really pissed off because the controls aren't that precise on the squid. So, I don't know. Was there anything else? I mean, again, it's probably my third
Sonic sucks.
Favorite game of this year.
Anyone who likes Sonic should die.
I need to try and play more good games before I do best and worst. I've played more than enough bad games and will probably still play some. Oh, this is something we could have talked about. It's not really gaming news. I don't really have footage for it either. But the Yik overhaul came out yesterday. Yik IV. And, I was actually considering streaming it, but from what I hear, it actually doesn't change that much. Despite supposedly being in development for like 5 fucking years... Basically, to sum it up, what they changed was, one, they got rid of all the annoying shit in the combat. Like, there's no, quick time event things like Paper Mario.
Yeah, but isn't that the fun part?
They cut down the loading screens by a lot. No, from what everyone else said, like, the shitty, like, mini games you have to do for attacks was part of the annoyance. Because it's for every attack. There's no, like, basic attack where you just don't do a mini game.
Well, Mario and Luigi's like that. Actually, so is Paper Mario.
Well, with it's different for Paper Mario because it's like, oh, hold backward or press A at the right time.
Yeah, that's hard. I have carpal tunnel.
It's a little bit... I don't remember the specifics because I watched all these Yik videos years ago now, but from what it seemed like, they got pretty fucking annoying, you know? But anyway, so they overhauled the combat shit. They added a lot more story. No, they didn't actually change the story, which you really think they would have changed some aspects of the story. Yik came out like 5 years ago, by the way, which is crazy. I couldn't believe it when someone said that. So it's like, what, Yik IV probably was in development at least 2, if not 3 years. They must have just been doing it during their free time because so little was actually changed. So, okay, so yeah, they added new story cutscenes. Do you know who Michael is?
No.
Okay,
bro,
so
I don't know anything about.
Oh, you don't know anything about Yik?
Literally nothing.
So Alex Yik, his best friend, quote unquote, Michael, was infamous as being a character that's introduced near the beginning, and then the story forgets about him after like the 2 hour mark, and he does almost nothing until the end of the game, and then he actually becomes like an omniscient, like, multiverse combination of Michaels. Well, apparently a new plot point in IV is that Michael was only pretending to be Alex's friend to get with his sister. So
that's good.
It made Alex even more of a loser than he already was. I mean, that's kind of funny, but at the same time, like, the whole point of the story, and this is part of the reason why I don't think there's any point in me playing it, is, like, I already know the story. I remember enough of it.
Yeah, that's the fun part.
The whole point is, like, the game isn't really real. Like, what's actually happening...
Yeah, it's, like, all in your head or whatever. You're, like, the center of the universe.
Yeah, basically. Like, every multiverse, Alex is, like, the most important thing in the universe. This is actually relevant to... Vaguely relevant to one of the movies we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about Deadpool and Wolverine, where that's... Sort of like the anchor being concept is sort of like
Kobe,
this.
I need you to refute this statement. This is a comment. Sonic Generations is boost slop for retards who couldn't take edgy Sonic from the 2000s and begged for irony Marvel shit with multiverse dark water and 2D crap. How's that make you feel?
I mean, there was a huge backlash against edgy shit from the 2000s. Every millennial decided it was mega ultra cringe. Let's all suck cocks ironically, you know, because that's cringe.
Sucking cock.
Yeah, sucking cock. Let's see.
It's cool as long as it's ironic.
Edge Kino, sucking cocks. Which one do I pick? I don't know. Well, millennials pick sucking cocks for some reason. Anyway, but so listen. You have to, it's campiness. It's just a different type of campiness. Like how Resident Evil 4 is a reference to 80s movie camp. The Edge Kino 2000s with like Shadow the Hedgehog with a gun. It's just a different form of campiness. I don't understand how people don't get this. It's really not that complicated or hard to understand. But yes, there was a huge backlash in the 2010s against the likes of Shadow, Jack 2, Prototype. You can name any number of things. Sonic games are so bad that, yes, people, even including me, are like, oh my god, Sonic Generations is awesome. It's like, no, it's just good in comparison to what came before. And Shadow Generations is just better than Sonic Generations in pretty much every way. So, yeah.
I agree. It's just you're going from like a 3 out of 10 to a 4 out of 10. So...
Yeah, I mean, you know, my brother hates everything and then likes the gay shit. What was that gay shit game you liked last time? What, the indie game?
One? The Dimensionals?
Yeah, that.
Yeah, that game.
I didn't even
sucks.
Know what it was called.
I haven't.
Oh, really? I thought you liked it.
Yeah, I don't know. It's one of those things where it's made for $3 or whatever because they were just like. It was a money laundering scheme. So once you played it one time, it's exactly the same. So
oh, okay.
Sucks.
Yeah. Let's talk about movies now, I guess.
Yay, movies.
We finally saw Deadpool and Wolverine because we haven't been to a theater in how many years now? At least 3. So we saw it on Disney Plus, obviously. And I did like it. I did like it. Not going to lie.
It was good.
You know, like the thing is, like, it's an ironic cape shit movie, which, you know what? The problem is that style of humor is so played out, but. It was done mostly tastefully, I would say. You know, I wouldn't say I loved a lot of the jokes, but there were a few really good ones in there. Like, especially the pedophile camp master joke that was near the end.
Yeah, no, there was enough master. Edge to it. Yeah. Like, I mean, it's not like the kind of things we would call edgy, you know?
Yeah.
But it definitely wasn't... It wasn't like Captain America humor or Guardians of the Galaxy humor.
Yeah. Yeah, they really shat on those Fox characters. That was kind of funny. But it's ironic because on the one hand, they shit on some of it. And then we're like, oh, no, we have to like give a proper conclusion now that they're never going to get sequels, which is kind of neat. Like, I mean, a lot of those movies are kind of ass. I mean, people like at least the first two Blade movies, or at least it depends on who you ask, I guess. I like the first two. The third one sucks. And everyone hated Daredevil, so obviously, like, they're gonna make fun of that shit. I don't know. It was kind of a neat concept, I guess, to be like, okay, these Fox characters live in, like, the dumpster of all the universes, I guess, since we have to do this shitty multiverse shit. Which, that was another good thing. That was the only part I really liked. There's only two parts I liked of the last 20 minutes. One of those was just Deadpool saying how, like, this multiverse shit is garbage. You know, like, stop doing it, Disney. Which, hopefully they listen, but I guess we'll see.
Yeah, because, I'm glad they did make this a point, is that whole, like, time shit, the time cops, is the gayest thing ever.
Yes. Yeah, that's so horrible.
And the fact that they expect you to take it seriously and like Loki and shit, is like obviously stupid. So I'm glad the movie took the piss.
These jets, dude. What the fuck, man? It's literally... Hey, Devin, can you get up and turn the light on in my room real quick?
Okay.
I hate to ask you. I don't want to get up. I'm the one sitting here on a webcam, so you do... Anyway, so if you need proof that we're in the same house, here you go. Fat fuck. Yeah, well.
Ooh, it's a spooky ghost. Who turned the light on and off?
Anyway, Nosferatu. Anyway, so I don't know. What'd you think of the worst Wolverine?
He was Wolverine. I couldn't tell the difference between him and every other Wolverine.
That is kind of that's such a weird thing that the movies sort of like. It plays such a fine line between like they take none as seriously, but also like you should take this seriously. Because like if you think about it, the worst Wolverine literally is just like, wow, these X-Men suits are gay as fuck. Like I don't want to be part of this. And that's it. He's the worst ever because he didn't want to wear the suit.
No, it's because he killed everyone.
I know, but I'm just saying, like, if you think about it.
I didn't know. I did think about it, and that's what I concluded. It's not because he thought
but
the suits
listen,
were too
if he
gay.
Thought the suits were cool, then he wouldn't have left his friends behind.
Yeah, but even then, they make it pretty clear that his friends, him letting his friends die wasn't the problem. I mean, that obviously wasn't good, but it wasn't the problem.
Yeah, they barely... That's a weird thing, too, is they kind of just brush over how he... You know, it's implied he just killed, like, a shit ton of humans. Like,
innocent people.
Like, yeah. He killed innocent people, yeah. It's like, yeah. That's interesting. But I like it, though, because they don't, like... Disney's too chicken shit to play into the racism thing, which the X-Men, obviously, are always associated with racism for obvious reasons. But, like, the thing is, okay... Listen, I've been a good boy, and now suddenly I don't want to be a good boy anymore, this podcast. But, like, let's just say, hypothetically, there was a race of people that looked just like us, but they could just, like, turn their hands into guns. Yeah. Wouldn't it make perfect sense to want to regulate that person, you know? Especially if...
No, because, well, there's a group of people who look just like us who's way more dangerous than that and has killed way more people, and we're not allowed to regulate them, so...
I don't know what you're talking about. You making shit up, you racist? What are you talking about?
That's I was talking about women.
Oh, okay. They never murder anybody, though. What do you mean? That's one of their justifications for hating men, is that men commit, like, 90% of the murders or whatever. Have you not seen the femcel subreddit?
Yeah, but we do it because it's necessary.
What murder is never necessary. Let the government change your diaper and give you money and be your daddy. and then, you know, sleep with Giga Chad in a white one night stand, blah, 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 et cetera, et cetera. I don't feel like going into this diatribe. Anyway, so the movie, right? Deadpool.
Yeah, we're talking about a movie.
Yeah, I got distracted by a Doomer Hour peaked in for a second. It was like, I haven't done one in so
Doomer
long.
Hour.
Yeah.
When Trump won, we got a whole hour of white pilling, and now it's back to Doomer Hour.
Yep. There wasn't enough seething. They've been hiding it. Google, those fucking loser ass cuckolds at Google are hiding the seething.
No, dude, have you seen, like, I know, like, iDubbbz was like this. They're like, oh, we're not mad at all. Actually, we thought Trump was going to win the whole time. It's like, everyone's lying. They can't help themselves.
Yeah, they're fucking, that's all they do is fucking lie. Oh, this is one of those stages I restarted a bunch of times because it took me forever to get on that top path consistently. I think I was doing this at like 3 a.m. Whatever. Ignore my bad gameplay. It was 3 a.m. I wasn't sleeping.
No, dude, anyway. Don't worry. It's because the game is bad, not because you're
bad. No. I'm bad. Because it's 3 a.m. Anyway, so... I don't know, man. This is one of those things where I feel like I figured I might have more to say as someone who, you know, used to watch all these cape shit movies. And, you know, I thought, you know, again, it was decently funny. But at the same time, like... I almost wish he had gone further with the multiverse joke and just said, all right, Disney, time to retire the MCU. Like, it's done. Like, who gives a fuck? Like, Deadpool doesn't even join in the end. Like, I get literally, basically, you know, the softcore, like, yeah, no, Deadpool's done. We're done. We made the three movies. No Deadpool. Fuck you. Yeah, fuck you, Disney. You get this character, and Ryan Reynolds won't even be him again. So...
Yeah, like, I didn't even think they were going to make two, let alone three, you know?
Yeah.
So, it's good enough. I'm okay with things dying. In fact, I'd rather have things die than just, like, slowly get shittier every iteration.
Yep. Okay, the Mario movie. Yeah, you were on you weren't even watching, you fuck.
I was reading a book.
All right, I saw the Mario movie, finally, I did. It made me kind of mad, I'll be honest. It did. Like, and not for the reasons you might think. Though, yes, I also hated Girl Boss Peach. And I love how the centrist grifter squad, whoever they may be, I don't know. Who am I referring to? I have no idea. A hypothetical. Stop restarting the stage. God damn it. Do it right. Fuck. All right, I'm just skipping past.
Yeah, it's the fun part. It's the fun part of the game.
Anyway.
Oh, nope, you're going to a shitty level again.
So, the Mario movie, yes. Yeah, if people pretending, I didn't know because I didn't watch the movie, but like leftists were making fun of whoever, some hypothetical group that doesn't exist, that they were saying, oh, the Mario movie's woke because Peach is tough because she has a halberd. It's like, Peach is unironically way more competent and useful and powerful and drives the plot more than Mario.
Yeah, no, every time I looked up from my book, I'm like, Peach is the main character.
Yeah, Peach is the main character of the fucking movie. Like, it's fucking, it's cringe, man. The only time, like, Mario really, like, earns it is when he beats Donkey Kong, and even then, it's because of, like, why did they even put Cat Mario in? Like, it's like marketing shit to, like, sell toys. This is the Mario Bros. Movie, and you pick fucking Cat Mario as the power-up? Fuck you. And you know what? The raccoon suit shows up near the end, which is fine, but that's good. I like that. But, like, eat a dick is all I'm saying. Anyway, so but the whole thing is soulless golem slop anyway. Like, I'll be honest, like, when they actually go into the Mushroom Kingdom, like, oh, you know what? This movie looks pretty good. It's got nice, like, highly saturated colors. And, you know, like, so much modern shit is, like, afraid to look good in a way, you know, whether it was like back in the PS3 generation, you had the piss filter and like everything was brown, but these days it's like the bisexual color scheme, but even then it's sort of like desaturated. I'm referring to like purple, pink, blue, everything is like, people have posted a shit ton of stuff that just splatters that all over everything. But you know, the Mario movie, at least at points, looked very colorful. But like that, it was such a fucking slop ass movie. The worst voice cast of all time, by the way, probably for an adaptation.
Dude, that's why I refuse to watch it. I'm like, oh, so Mario doesn't sound like Mario. Not watching.
They make fun of it in the first 30 seconds. His family's like, "What the fuck was that accent you did?" I'm like, "Oh, I don't know. That's Mario's fucking voice. You." Fucking, and I was like, you know, I like you saw like the Hitler stash grow on me in real time, and I said things that should never be repeated on the internet. But
dude, I hate this millennial writing where it's like, make fun of thing everyone loves, you know? Where it's like, why do you feel the need to make fun of something that's better than you?
Yeah.
Fuck you.
You know, and like Seth Rogen as Donkey Kong again. I was like, you know,
that's the worst.
You start hearing some patriotic Germans, you know, in the background.
Dude, he even did the Seth Rogen laugh.
He did. Like, oh my god, it was so bad, dude. I used my time freeze a really bad place. Yeah, I froze time at the wrong time. So, yeah, I don't know, dude. Like, especially the end. Like, again, Luigi's the damsel in distress instead of Peach. Not woke, by the way. Not woke. What does woke mean? I literally got recommended some gay-ass fucking... I didn't even click on it because I'm like, I don't even want to hear 5 seconds of this homo's voice. But it was like, you know, it was another, like, mocking what woke means video. It's like, you fuckers can't even define it. How do you make fun of something that you don't even know what it means? Like, oh, is this woke? Oh, yeah, I think the video was called, like, trying to figure out what's woke. And it's like, is Mario woke? Is like the thumbnail or whatever, something like that. I'm like,
no, dude, I'm on the boomer side now. Shit. Where woke just means anything I don't like, fuck you, face the wall. You know?
Based. There you go. I mean, how hard is it that, like, these fuckers pretend they don't even know what their own ideology is? Legitimately, it's cultural Marxism or progressive leftism, whatever. You could, there's like 10 different names for it. The thing you fucks believe, the literally your ideology, that's what woke means. It's that fucking simple. Oh, do you believe girl bosses are good? Then it's woke, because you think it's good, fucker. Yeah, that's what you're promoting. Breathing is woke.
No. Yeah. You breathing is woke.
Yeah. Stop breathing, bitch. You thinking different than me and being alive is woke. So stop being alive. Anyway, so anyway, uh-oh, my playlist. Oh no, that has like 20 seconds of silence at the end of it. I was panicking without the music. Yeah. Anyway, so
the autism was. You're hearing voices in your head again.
That's always that's you and me though, like especially like maybe that's why I hate straw man as a fallacy, because like every hypothetical argument in my head is a straw man, but they're all true though, so is it a straw man? Like they're based on things I've actually heard people say, so that's not a straw man then. Like, but I didn't come up with something.
A straw man of the left. Because, trust me, there's some psycho.
Yeah, they all believe. Anything I've ever thought that they've believed is something they do believe. So that's not a straw man.
And if they don't believe it now, they will in the future.
Yeah, it's also true. Which is why people keep saying they're going to normalize being a pedo, at least in certain kinds of it. You know, that's the part people don't mention, though. I don't want to get into that because it's an old quote of mine. You know what I'm talking about? Where it's like, if you go deep enough into the internet, it's just gay pedos versus straight pedos. I said something like that. And I'm like, I think about that sometimes. Like, that is so true, though. Like, people don't want to talk about it. But, like, especially all the lolly people in my audience, you know who you are. That exactly is proving my fucking point. But anyway, so the Mario movies. Maybe man.
Back to the Mario
movie. So it was Sola's Golem slop. Illumination sucks. I hate them. They ruined everything. Fuck Hollywood. Fuck, you know, the toucans who are from space. And fuck you. Okay, now let's talk about House, the best episodic TV show of all time. House is really
good. My favorite
though.
Show ever created. I love House. And you explained to me why. I never really thought why it was my favorite show. I just thought it was the best written and it's good. But go ahead and explain what you said to me.
Yeah, because it's just a show about an angry white man being right all the time. Yeah,
he's always
and
right.
Everyone opposes him. Like, they always doubt him. And you know what? Temporarily, he's wrong until he's right. Eventually, he is always correct.
And there's always a dumb woman who
Who's in his way? Women, minorities.
Yep.
Especially women, though. Especially women.
Yeah, especially women. And they're like, I'm going to do it my way. And then it backfires.
Yes,
every time.
And he's right every goddamn time.
It happened three times.
Yeah, that show is too based. Way too fucking based.
It's so good. And it's like, I never thought about it like that. I'm just like, I think House is cool. And it's like, no, it's angry white man who's always right. It's like, perfect.
And that shows a lot of casual racism in it, too. That's I love the casual racism.
It's great. Yep.
But yeah, no, I mean, all that base stuff aside, it actually is good TV drama and a very good use of episodic formula. You know, it's still engaging. Even if you know the flow of every episode, it doesn't matter because it's very well written. It's funny. It's dramatic, you know. And yeah, like, you know, as you were telling me, the two-parter with Foreman dying, that was quite good, actually, you know? Because, like, at the end of the day, like, you know, it doesn't matter if, like, you're allowed to have, like, racist jokes in something and it not be racist. Now, that's something that literally nobody understands anymore. Like, to, like, your average, like, Zoomer, that doesn't compute at all. What do you mean? This is racist? Fuck you. You racist. How dare you, you know? It's like...
No, before, everything had racist jokes because it just wasn't a big deal. Who cares?
Yes.
Like, everyone says and believes racist things. Everyone. All the time. They just, now people just lie about it and hide it.
Yep.
Unless it's about white people, then it's fine.
Yeah, I mean, you're allowed to be racist toward white men, especially, for sure. I don't know why women are exempt from that a lot of times. It's weird. Like, actually, it's okay to be racist against white women if it's friendly fire from conservatives. That happens a lot. You know, that happens even sometimes when we talk about stuff like the dog. You just know with dogs or like, you know, other things that I won't say. You get what I'm saying. So, I don't know. I just felt like mentioning House briefly. Like, you guys should all watch it if you haven't. It's aged extremely well. Okay, I think it's finally time to talk about the rest of the 1988 games.
Oh my God.
Finally. Okay, so if you remember last week, we talked about Super Mario Bros. 3, Ninja Gaiden, what was the other one? We talked about three games, I think.
We did?
I
thought it was just those two.
Mega Man 2. That was the other
one.
Yeah, Mega Man
2. Yeah, that was the other
great I had to check the list.
Did you want to just put those on really quick?
Super Mario Bros. 3 is game of the year. That's obvious.
Easy.
Now, must play is always the hard one, because it's like, I don't...
Mega Man 2. I it's a good game.
Mega Man 2 is, probably the second best game that I played out of these, for sure.
And I didn't play Gaiden. Yeah,
Ninja Gaiden, I guess, is worth a try, but only with save states. Only with save states. Trust me. I don't care how good at video games you are. You're wasting your goddamn time. Just cheat. Just fucking cheat. It's not worth getting good at the game to play all the way through. Well, I didn't play Blaster Master, but you did, right?
Yeah.
So,
You can just place it really quick. Yeah, it's just okay. Just put it in worth a try. It's too hard to be fun, but the remake is pretty solid in a, I don't know, like mediocre indie game kind of way.
Would you like to explain to the class what Blaster Master is, since I have no footage to show?
It's just Tank. He plays a little tank guy, and it's a very, very early Metroidvania. That's it. With levels. It's a Metroidvania with levels.
Okay. Also, in case this one guy asks, no, I didn't play Wasteland either. Maybe I will get around to it.
Yeah, I played it for like 15 minutes in twice, but I don't know. I didn't like Fallout 1. I think there's no universe I was going to like Wasteland. Sad.
Hold on. There we go. We can play Tetris. I also didn't record anything for Tetris, but I think everyone's played Tetris. Devin, you like Tetris.
I love Tetris. Tetris is fun. I'd put it in must play. You gotta play Tetris. You can't just not play Tetris.
I guess I agree, if only because it's the type of game where you lose nothing. Everyone pretty much likes it. I don't really care about it that much, but it's fine. And yeah, everyone should try it because it's like it's extremely simplistic and you might like it. So you have almost nothing to lose. It's been released 1,000 times, you know. So yeah, we can put Tetris in must play, even if it's for a different reason than I would normally think. You'd put something in must play. Okay, so now we'll talk about the games I actually have footage for. Let's talk about the game I put the most time into is Dragon Quest III.
And the one I put the least time into.
That's fine. I think.
So I'll go with your judgment. It's just Dragon Quest. It's the same game over and over and over again.
Yeah, so I played the HD remaster, whatever the fuck you want to call it. They did, yes, it is, some stuff is censored, unfortunately. But yeah, the sad thing is, this is, like, even with this, like, fancy, you know, you got cutscenes, you got voice acting for important characters, all this shit. At the end of the day, it's still Dragon Quest. Like, as we'll talk about with Final Fantasy II, after this, it still has no story. Like, this, I mean, later games do have more of a story in Dragon Quest, but these first few games, it's extremely bare bones. You know, you're the hero, your dad gets killed, and you have to, you know, succeed in his place to defeat the evil wizard Baramos. And, you know, Baramos is not the real bad guy, I know, because of other games. Zoma is, but that's not important. Dragon Quest actually does that multiple times, where there's a fake-out mid-game boss bad guy who gets superseded by the real bad guy. Yeah, I mean, I hate to say it, but yeah, it's just fucking Dragon Quest. Like, if I just skip to the... Well, this clip... one thing... This is like Dragon Quest IX in the sense that you create your own party and they don't have character, really. I took the default mage, white mage, priest, because, I mean, you always are going to have a healer. But I made a female warrior, unfortunately, slightly censored. But, I mean,
it
you
really
can...
It isn't that
Yeah,
much.
You can tell from this pixel art here. I'm not going to bother zooming in. I was like, even if you... You're not gonna be able to see it on your phone, probably. But you can see at the top here, it's still a pretty skimpy outfit, let's be honest. So, I mean, I would prefer they don't censor anything, but... I mean, her ass... They literally have pixels for her ass cheeks hanging out on the backside. So, just you know, throwing that out there. So, I did that. And yes, I named her Abby because I... Fuck it. Let's just play into it.
Dude, the brain damage is permanent. Like, that's never gonna leave your psyche.
Yeah, and then I made a Monster Wrangler just because I wanted to try a different class, and I really like that design. I don't know, I'm a sucker for, like, the white-haired, like, anime chick who's, like, you know...
I guess it's genetic.
...neutral though. Something. Oh, you also like that?
Yeah, that's what it is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Monster Wrangler is one of those classes that kind of sucks in the early game. I hear it gets really good later, but it's just kind of like... a jack-of-all-trades type class, which your character already is that, but like it does a little...
No point.
Yeah, there's no point. The hero class already is the jack-of-all-trades, so Monster Wrangler, it can heal, it has, you know, a multi-target hit attack, it can stun an enemy, but I never use that move. But later it learns, like, really good shit from what I saw, but I didn't play that far. Alright, we'll skip to gameplay. The gameplay, again, it's literally just Dragon Quest. If you played a Dragon Quest game, it's the same exact fucking combat in every one of these games.
Dude, it's crazy, because everyone makes fun of,
Oh, I sped it up later.
Right?
Yeah,
for being the same game. But, like, Call of Duty could never dream of copy and pasting as bad as Dragon Quest does.
I feel like I was...
The Japanese love it! They love it.
I need to, like, take a shit at some point. Why? Half of this, I'm not even... Okay, here we go. This should be combat here. I'm, like, literally just trying to find when I'm playing the game. Like, what was I doing? Whatever. Anyways.
We know what you're doing.
No, I swear I wasn't. Far. No. Not at the same time as this. I swear. Anyway.
You saw the warrior design, the female warrior design. You had to take a break.
Yeah. Yeah, man, it's really just not that interesting. So basically, like, it, you know, if you played any JRPG, the roles are the same. The hero class is a glorified warrior class that also has a couple spells, so you can heal and you can AoE burn. What's vaguely interesting is, like, enemies are divided into groups, so group spells don't hit every opponent, they only hit a group. So you can fight up to, like, 8 or 10 enemies at once, but they're split into groups. I can probably skip to a combat sequence, but, like, you'll have a group of, like, 3 heal slimes, and then there's one toad or one anteater guy.
And that was already the case in Dragon Quest 2.
I didn't play it. I forgot.
Yep.
Yeah, I skipped Dragon Quest 2.
So don't worry, there actually was zero innovation, if you thought there was some.
Yeah. So, the thing is, okay, so I'm gonna slightly defend Dragon Quest here. Because this is something that I noticed. The main difference, other than basically the games being exactly the same every time, the main difference between Final Fantasy and Dragon Quest is Dragon Quest takes the gameplay part a little bit more seriously. In the sense that dungeon crawling actually is resource management in Dragon Quest. Because the average combat encounter is more difficult than Final Fantasy, without a doubt. Like, it just wears you down over time.
They do that in different ways in Final Fantasy, though. Because, like, think of the poison cave in Final Fantasy 1. It's like, the individual encounters aren't very strong, but it's just meant to sap your mana, and then you slowly die of poison, right?
Yeah. And me and you already talked about this off stream, but this is not real challenge. This is artificial difficulty. I'll skip to when I got past Tutorial Island.
Because all it is the game making you grind. You know?
Yeah, you have... Yeah, exactly. Because
you are artificially... you'll always either increase your money enough to get to new equipment, at which point it's not a challenge anymore, or you level up enough to the point where it's not a challenge anymore.
Yeah,
resource management only exists if you're underleveled. And by playing the game, that it, you know, it's a problem that solves itself.
Yeah, and this is one of those games where equipment is more important than levels, and it takes a really long time to level up, actually, as well. So, as you just saw there, my priest got killed in, like, 3 hits because I was under-equipped because I didn't grind for enough money, right? It wasn't even about EXP, it's about I need to grind just to fucking get gold to buy better shit.
Like, if you just watch this, the game is forcing you to grind, because now you have to walk back to town to revive. So all that progress you made has been reset, but you kept all of the money and experience you just got. So it's just forcing you to grind. That's all it's doing.
Yeah, exactly. One thing the remake adds is, along with the Monster Wrangler class, you can find monsters out in the overworld. Unfortunately, you can't train them. You can fight with them in the arena here. No, that was the end. I only did the intro battle, though.
Innovation for innovation's sake is not necessarily a good thing. It's the same fucking game! Just replay the one you already have! There's no differences. None. Literally zero. For, like, 40 fucking years. It's insane. Fuck these games.
Yeah, I mean, again, if you just compare...
I like Dragon Quest 1, and then I play Dragon Quest 2, and I'm like, oh, it's the same game. And then I play Dragon Quest 3, and I'm like, this is the same game. And I'm like, wait a second. I played Dragon Quest 9 when I was a kid, and that's the same fucking game. And then, what, a year ago, I played Dragon Quest 11, which is still the same game. What is wrong with the Japanese? What,
yeah, well,
do they have brain worms?
If you defend this, you defend Call of Duty being the same every year, basically. The only
Call
difference...
Call of Duty is way more different than any of these are.
Well, that's the funny
that's
thing,
still
yeah.
Too similar.
In terms of, like, the fact that these are all the same basic fantasy setting every time. Like, Final Fantasy will mix it up. It'll have, like, ancient advanced technology, or it'll take place in the future. Or it's just, like, they always, like, mix in, like, a weird amount of, like, either cyberpunk stuff or, like, weird, like, ancient magi technology type stuff to mix it up. It's a different setting. Most of the time, it feels like a different one. With Dragon Quest, it's the same exact fantasy setting every goddamn time, which makes it feel even more the same. You know, the monsters' designs are the same because, you know, Toriyama drew, like, 100 monsters that they just they only add like three or four new ones each game. You know, they recycle the same
and the monster
monsters.
Designs are amazing. They're perfect. They're great. But you can't use the same ones over and over and over again.
Yeah, so, you know, I don't know. It, like, shockingly, though, I could see myself finishing this, weirdly. Same for Final Fantasy II, though. I was actually decently engaged with Final Fantasy II. But these are, like, if
well, I'm getting mad over that comment still. Innovation for innovation's sake. You don't even know what you're saying. What you said doesn't mean anything. Stop pretending like it does. It's magic words to get the other guy to think you're smart. But you're a retard, and I know you're a retard.
I'm so glad you're saying this shit, man. You're seeing what I have to deal with when I stream, and then people insult me afterward like I was wrong. It's like, what are you talking about? I was 100% correct with everything I was saying. It's like, you are literally just saying exactly what I would say. What I would say.
I'm sorry, I could tell you.
Anyway. So anyway. So, I don't know, like, right, my final thoughts on this, really, is that this is just a worse version of Dragon Quest IX. Like, if you're gonna play a game where you create your own party and you go off on an adventure across the world in this medieval fantasy thing, I think Dragon Quest IX does this, but just does it better, in the sense that Dragon Quest IX has a unique way of doing a story, where instead of having basically no story, like Dragon Quest, it's an episodic story where it's a bunch of mini, like, Monster of the Week areas, and Thomas is in chat, I just noticed. Anyway, it's a bunch of mini, like, stories in each area you go to across the map. You solve all these people's problems. Like, one is like, oh, here's a giant whale, or oh, here's like an evil witch who resurrected this dude that she was in love with and made him like a black knight or whatever. Here's one where it's like a Harry Potter school, you know, or there's like a desert with like a little lizard dude who wished to be a giant fat lizard dude because he was in love with the queen or something. I that's a weird one now I'm thinking about it. Yeah, that's a bestiality yeah. story. Anyway, point is, Dragon Quest, I remember that all off the top of my head. I haven't played Dragon Quest IX in over a decade, but it is memorable because I haven't really played an RPG that did something like that. So, but this is just more of the same, you know? If you're going to play more of the same of Dragon Quest, you should just play the Pokemon ripoff games. Like, last year I put The Dark Prince is my fifth best game of the year, because I like those games. It just takes, like, the Dragon Quest formula and adds, like, interesting progression on top of it, because everyone likes catching monsters and fighting with them, you know? So, you know, I don't know. I like it anyway.
Yeah, are those, like, ultra grindy, though?
Yes. Yep. Yeah. Yep, they're ultra grindy.
As opposed to Pokemon,
sure,
which is, like, ultra soul and has no grind if you're not mentally retarded.
Yeah, I mean, I would definitely not say they're better than Pokemon. They're definitely not. But they're fun in their own way.
Okay.
Super Mario Bros. 2, I only played for 15 minutes, so this won't
take long. That's not very long. I played like halfway through. It's fine. It's okay.
Well, yeah, you can talk about this.
Super Mario Bros. 3.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, you want to talk about it?
Well, this game's so remarkable. I had three things to say about it. Easiest wall clips I've ever seen. Okay, that's cool, I guess. Mouse bad. Oh, yeah, the mouse boss. You never fought him?
I did. Yeah, he was at the end of the first world. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you fight him multiple times. Fuck that guy. He's annoying. And level design is just kind of annoying, where you're wandering around. So I guess that's more apparent in the later levels. The beginning's pretty linear.
Yeah, I like the beginning. Like, I like just the platforming parts, but anything that's not platforming around, it kind of sucks.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. There's some interesting concepts. Like, I like taking the key and then the mask chases you and you got to outrun them.
Oh, yeah, that's super cool. Yeah. I don't know. I played this immediately after Super Mario Bros. 3, so I just found it unremarkable.
Yeah, I mean, it's no contest between the two of them. I die here in a very stupid way. I just slipped off the edge. Yep. but yeah, I don't know. Like, yeah, it's one of those games where if I had infinite time and I actually, you know, for some reason didn't want to play any better games, I think it'd be completely fine. But yeah, there's literally, there's no reason to like dedicate a shit ton of time playing this. I say that, but it's probably only like 2 to 3 hours long. But really, Thomas, we're literally doing the fucking podcast, you retard. Thomas is texting. You asswipe. Anyway, so it's one of those things where I like interesting ideas, and this has interesting ideas, like just basing so much of the game around like picking stuff up below you. I fucking missed that jump like 5 times. I was getting tilted after a certain point. But anyway, at the end of the day, like it isn't like that fun to play.
Yeah,
it's just it's fine. It really is.
That's what I was thinking. I was just like, I don't feel the need to finish this because it's just another NES game that's okay.
Yeah. It's like if you compare it to like, again, we're only trying to play the best games. If we were playing the worst games, we'd be like, oh, this is probably one of the best NES games. But it's like that. That's a low bar. That's like a really fucking low bar. You know, you watch any AVGN episode and you're like, wow, that's a lot of dog shit. You know?
Yeah.
But yeah, if we're comparing it to the best, it's just, it's okay. You know, it's fine. All right. I guess that's it for that then. Yeah, so shit tier then?
No. No, it's definitely better than Gaiden.
Yeah, no, it's fine. It's fine. Yeah.
It's okay.
Okay, and then the final game for 88, which I have thrown this idea around. Again, we're not committing to anything. But since we've ended up skipping a lot of chat requested games, we may come back to this. We haven't decided when we're going to stop. Like, honestly, if it were up to me, 2013 would probably be the last year. Because I just don't care about, like, modern gaming like that, you know? We could go all the way up until, like, 2020. But, like, let's say if we just hit the greatest from now to 2013, then we could go back and play the less praised games, you know, on a second time around. It was an idea I put forward. I don't know if we're going to do that. Okay, so last one, Final Fantasy 2. Both of us, I think, were pleasantly surprised by this one.
Yeah, dude, I played through the whole thing. I love this game. This game's great.
Yeah.
Which is funny, because all the shitters say this is the bad Final Fantasy, but I liked it more than 1, and I liked it more than 7, so it must be pretty good.
Well, liking more than 7 is like actual maniac talk,
well,
but
7 is dog shit. Anyone who likes Final Fantasy 7 should die. That's another one where, yeah, that game's woke because I don't like it. Anyway, Final Fantasy 2.
Well, yeah, Final Fantasy 2, it has a story. That's innovation. We're talking innovation. It actually has a fucking story, which is crazy. You know, a novel concept back then, actually. But, yeah,
It's, like, not the greatest story ever, but it is reasonably told. It's pretty quick, not boring. Everyone dies for some reason, which is cool.
Spoiler.
Like, one person died while you were still playing. Just know that happens to, like, almost everyone. Like, there's so much death in this game, it's crazy.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, this might be one I actually finish, because I was somewhat engaged. Again, I think my standards are getting pretty low, because like NES games is so simplistic.
Yeah.
That I might come back to finish this maybe.
Skip ahead to the dialogue system, because the dialogue system's so cool in this game.
Yeah, hold on. Yeah, where you have key terms, and then
you learn from people talking about them, and then you can ask anyone you talk to about those key terms.
That was a good idea.
An NES game, so obviously it's not like that broad, but it's just it's cool. It makes the dialogue slightly more engaging.
Yeah. Oh yeah, so the RPG mechanics in this are ironically one of the more interesting parts. It's like Bethesda, where you use a skill and then you get better at the skill. And it applies to all your stats too. You get hit, your HP stat goes up. It's like, and each individual magic has proficiencies as well. And it's like, that's interesting. I mean, I don't think that's better than the normal way, but everything else, like, again, if you do the same thing 1,000 times, anything else is going to feel fresh.
And yeah, and this is only Final Fantasy 2. Just comparing Dragon Quest 1 to Dragon Quest 3, where it's the same fucking game over and over again, all the way up to Dragon Quest 11. And then Final Fantasy 1 to 2 are completely different. Like, literally, the combat leveling up system is completely different than it was in the first game, that they never did again. This is the only game that does this in all Final Fantasy.
The only thing I would be worried about, but you played through most of this, but the only thing I'd be... this game too.
Oh, I beat this game.
Oh, you beat it. Okay, so how grindy does it get with the skills?
Not at all. I never grinded the entire game, and I turned encounters off like the entire second half of the game. So you just kind of have to accept that. I guess the only annoying thing is it once you get a new spell, you're like more upset than you are happy, because you have to, like, it's gonna be shit for the next 2 hours, you know?
Right, yeah.
But no, yeah, the only problem I ran into was the final boss. I basically had to kill with poison because I was doing so little damage.
I forgot.
But no, the game is not grindy at all.
I forgot I actually had a couple tracks for when we were going to talk about the retro games. Too late now, since we already talked about Dragon Quest, but I'll just switch to the Dragon Quest music. That is one thing Dragon Quest has over... Not all the Final Fantasy soundtracks, but over the early ones at least, is the Dragon Quest soundtrack is much better, in my opinion.
The game's just cool. It's pretty freeform, but like for no reason. Like, you can go in any direction, but if you go the wrong way, you just get one shot and die.
Yeah, I did that. Yep, I did that one time. Just, oh, I can go southwest here. Oh, everyone died in one hit. Wow. And the same thing with the fucking guards in the third place.
Yeah. Like, it shows you how they're not just telling you, hey, these guards are really strong. They're like, no, go ahead. Try and fight them, pussy.
Yeah, here we go. Well, right here. All right, so yeah. Yes, I will defeat the Empire. Zero damage. And then 25 damage. 25.
And that's why magic is good.
311. Run! So that's fun. I mean, modern games are scared of doing shit like that.
Yeah, because everyone's a pussy. They're like, I don't want to play this game anymore.
That was one of the things, even though it was handled in a very lazy way, I did like it about Breath of the Wild. You know, you could go anywhere and then get killed in one hit.
Yep. I don't know. You didn't, like, play enough to notice this, but if you don't use a guide, there's, like, a shit ton of running back and forth in this game, just talking to everyone, trying every keyword. That's kind of the only annoying thing about the keyword system.
Yeah. Well, that does sound annoying, but I guess I'll figure that out later if I don't bother using a guide.
It's not that bad. Like, you can definitely beat the game without a guide. It's not like you need it. What's cool about this game having a story is that it's done well, better than a lot of modern games, and that things that happen in the story have permanent world changes. Like, a town will just get destroyed, and now it's forever gone, you know?
You know, it's funny. Normally, I'd say that's a good thing, but if they watched my last Stalker 2 stream, they'd see how that could be a bad thing.
Oh, yeah? What happens in Stalker 2?
You know that Science Institute thing I showed you? After that gets destroyed, the fucking feds hate you, and one of the early outposts that I didn't discover, like, in the early game, I needed, like, to buy something there. I think it was, like, I could get a better suppressed pistol. And so I show up there the first time and everyone starts shooting me. And I'm like, what the fuck? Oh. I was so pissed. I'd been playing the game for 4 fucking hours. I just wanted to do one last thing. The game was already torturing me. And then I'm like, oh, this settlement just hates me. And I didn't even know why until I figured it out.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
No, luckily this game was smarter than that, in that, like, even the destroyed town still has a working inn and stuff.
Oh yeah, that's good.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a good game. I like this game.
Okay, and that was all of them.
That was the last one.
So we'll talk about the 1988. Hold on. Yeah, where do you want to put it?
I say must play. I like this game a lot.
Really?
Yeah. I think people saying this is the worst Final Fantasy are insane. Like, this is my favorite one by far so far.
I told you guys Devin's the biggest contrarian of all time.
I don't know. I like good games. What do you want from me? Bro Jared gave Metal Gear Rising, a 4 out of 10, and he said this is the worst one. Who are you going to believe?
Yeah, it's true. I mean, well, you're understanding in real time where why people get less pissed about someone overrating something than underrating it, you know? If yeah. you
well,
shit
that's
on
why I want people to be mad at me still. That's why I have to attach it to me hating Final Fantasy VII.
Listen, it's every not... time you hate Devin, just think about Poir, and then everything will be fine. yes.
Man, people are, like, really mad. He is retard. Good job.
Anyway, Poir. So, I don't know. Must play seems like too generous.
No, dude, it's good. You haven't played it.
Well, maybe we'll revise it later. Who cares? The ultimate list is what matters more. Yeah, so, yeah. Right, we need to fix this anyway. So, because, yeah, we need to put back the other ones. Okay, so Super Mario Bros. 3 is A tier up with Zelda for sure.
Yep.
We'll put back Ghosts and Goblins.
You said you wanted to clean. Well, we can discuss this with chat. That the list will get too bloated over time, and this is supposed to be the greatest games of all time. Do you want us to slowly shave off games if they're too bad?
Yeah, that's a good yeah, maybe I could just make that a poll instead of getting random yes nos. Should we shave off the worst games over time?
Dude, people really like Final Fantasy VII. I didn't realize you had this many gay people in your chat.
Listen, the beginning of Final Fantasy VII is really good. I'll say that. The middle is kind of meandering.
Yeah, but the beginning's not even that long. I played through the beginning. I had fun in the beginning, and then the rest of the game happens.
Yeah, I think the last, like, 5 hours is good, too. But, yeah, the beginning and the end are great, but, yeah, the middle is not that great. Which is why fucking Rebirth is shit, because it's just the middle. And then the end is when something actually happens. You have to play all the way to the end of the game to get to the most important part.
I never even made it to Aerith dying. That middle part's just so boring.
Yeah, well, that's where it picks up again. The combat is bad. That's a legitimate problem. All right, what do you think for Mega Man 2? Do we put that in A tier 2, or what do we want?
Dude, we're a little too fast and loose with our tiers. That's here. Let's do put that back. Put Mega Man 2 back. Let's do Stalker and Shadow first. So we have like an anchor point, because we're looking at too many. God, really? You tried to tell me Shadow is as good as the first Legend of Zelda. No, okay, I think that's fun.
There you go.
Like, I just think we need something to compare it to. So when we say, it's like Final Fantasy 1 really better than Stalker 2?
I don't know. A Stalker 2 isn't a D. I was just being an ass, kind of. Okay. I don't know. Like, I feel like after patches, it would be...
Because I told you I, like, renamed the tiers to be more positive, and that these are, like, degrees of positive. Maybe we can change the wiggle room later.
Yeah. It seems sort of split down the middle on the should we shave off the worst game. The only reason I don't agree is just because I feel like if someone pops into the most recent podcast episode, they're going to be like, well, what happened to all those other games, you know?
Oh, I guess that's fair. I don't know. It was your idea, sir.
Well,
don't put this on me.
I don't know. We'll think about it. Anyway, regardless, I feel like Stalker 2 after patches would probably be B tier if they fix the game. But right now, it's like a C, I'd say.
Okay, so do we legitimately believe that Mega Man 1 is a whole tier better than Stalker 2?
No. No.
Yeah, see, okay, that's what I thought.
Now we just don't have a B tier, though.
That's fine. All right.
Yeah, Ninja Gaiden's probably C. Mega Man 2 might be the one B tier one.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking, where I'm like, okay, yeah, put Mega Man 2 up in B. Except, if we're doing that, put Shadow Generations down one. Fuck that
fine.
Shit game for babies.
It's good, though. Wait, hold on, though. Wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
Nah, wait, I don't agree with this anymore. Remember, well, I don't know if we're still going to do this, but in my head, I'm translating these tiers as, like, numbers out of 10. So, goat is 10, S is 9, A is 8. Shadows absolutely is an 8, then.
No, 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 but I think that's too far. I think we should do, you know, it's like...
What, goat is 11?
Goat is 10, S is, like, 95, A is 9. Because we're talking about only... Like, eventually, we're going to have so many amazing games that we'll have no differentiation if it's not that... specific, you know?
Yeah, well, that's maybe more important for down the line, I guess. Yeah, but yeah, if you're thinking 10, oh, 9.
Okay, okay.
5,
if we're not
9,
talking about the future, 5. Go ahead and put Generations at the bottom, because it's a shit game for autistic
fuck
people.
You. Well, no, because listen, if it's... Think about it this way. Then we need more tiers, because if Go is 10, S is 9.5, A is 9...
No, I was thinking there'd be a huge jump to just anything below a, you know, 7 isn't even worth thinking about.
Okay, then all these are going poo-poo, then.
Yes, that's what I was thinking. I don't know, like, but that's a future problem, I think, because right now there is a point in differentiating.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We'll do that later. Right. Let's see. Okay, so we didn't talk about Pac-Man. Do you want to talk about Pac-Man? I mean, Pac-Man. You like Pac-Man more than me.
Just put it in C, though. It's just fucking Pac-Man, dude. I don't, it's fun, but...
Mario Bros. Is probably D. I don't think it's very good. It's fine. Yeah,
that's fine. I agree. Put it. Throw it.
This is Dragon Quest 1.
Put it in poo poo. I changed my mind completely on that game. Poo poo.
Oh, Dragon Quest 1?
Yeah, yeah. Throw that shit in poo poo.
Okay.
Fuck that game.
I feel like this is. What will be funny is, see, we're not there yet. But once we get like 10 more years ahead of where we're right now, so that'll be like in a year at this rate. People are gonna fucking just the Zoomer allegations will be through the fucking roof. Cause
what
like
you mean? We
the
have
most
Zelda 1 and A tier.
No, fucking Vex.
No Zoomers even played that game.
Vex is gonna be S tier, and it's a fucking mid 3D platformer. That's what I'm saying, though. Like, I don't know. It's impossible to make this year that nostalgia. Like Spyro is gonna be in a tier above Goat. That's just called Spyro.
Spyro's actually that good, though.
Anyway.
You thought I disagreed with you, but it's a great game.
Anyway, so whatever. Castlevania 1 is probably D. I don't know. I don't think it's FUBU.
D's fun.
Is this Dragon Quest 2?
Dragon Quest
2? Yeah, poop. Okay.
Throwing poop.
Okay.
Poop.
I didn't play 2.
Excitebike's
poop. What? Excitebike's better than these? I'd rather play Zelda 2 than Excitebike.
All right, fine. Throwing poop. Who cares?
Okay. Gradius. Everyone hates us for this take.
I don't care. Throw it in poop.
All right. Ice Climber's poop.
Yep.
Kid Icarus, D, maybe?
Yeah. Throw it in D.
Super Mario Bros. 2, D, probably. Or no, this is the Lost Levels. What would you give
Lost Levels? But just put it at the top of D. Like, it's definitely better than Mario 1, but whatever.
Metroid's probably C. Ultima 4, I don't know. What?
Poop.
Yeah.
Anger the PC gamers.
Tetris, what do you think? Tetris C?
Yeah, just throw it C, whatever, it's fine.
Dragon Quest 3. Yeah, I don't know. Like, because I played a remake that doesn't really count. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
like, if I played the original, it'd be poop. Yeah.
It's even more poop.
Blaster Master.
D, just throw it in D.
Okay, it's and fine. Then Final Fantasy 2.
I'd put in B. Throw in B.
People are definitely going to make fun of you for this shit, but I don't care enough. I will play more, and I will come back.
Yeah, you can yell at me when you played it. It's good.
Okay, so we have no S tiers and no goats, and we're...
No, people want Tetris and goat.
So this is the fourth year we've done, and we have no S's or goats. That's something.
No, dude, like, bump Mario Bros. 3 up. Bump it.
Yeah, Mario Bros. 3 is S.
Just bump it up. I love that game. Yeah. It's so good. I'd play it again right now. Bump it up. That's it. What I changed one of the names to of the tiers was like pinnacle of the genre. And I genuinely think Mario Bros. 3 is the best 2D platformer of that style. You know, where it's like no, you know, it's not like the rage platformers like Celeste or Super Meat Boy.
Yep. Okay, well, there you go. You want to hear whatever the Z-lennial slash Zoomer opinion of the week is. Here it is. There you go.
Perfect. Beautiful.
Well, we will adjust these later. I know we will, for sure.
Oh, yeah. Well, because, like I said, the human brain, everything is done by comparison. And we have no good modern games on the list to, like, compare. So everything is, like, in that realm of, well, it's good for an NES game, and, you know.
Yeah, maybe next week we should add games that have come out in the past 5 years that at least I've played so that we can throw them against some of these, you know.
Sure.
Yeah, we'll talk about that later, I guess.